وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين له بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about that Ramadan is jami'ul arkan. Ramadan, it gathers in it, all of the five pillars of Islam are in it. The month of Ramadan, all of the five pillars of Islam are in it. And that's what we're going to discuss, inshallah ta'ala. The first of the five pillars of Islam is at-tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and worshipping Allah tabarak wa ta'ala alone. Tawheed's real meaning and the essence of at-tawheed is al-ikhlas, sincerity. It is to single Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in the acts of worship that you do. The poet, he said, ikhlasuna lillahi saffi al-qalba min iradatin siwahu fahdhar ya fatin. Ikhlas means that your heart is stripped from anyone else except Allah. That's the only person you have in your mind. Ala lillahi ad-dinul khalis. The whole entire religion is sincerity. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. They were commanded to worship Allah based on sincerity. Fasting symbols and shows the concept of sincerity more than any other action. ولذلك, the great scholar Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, he said, جَمِيعُ الْعِبَادَاتِ, all of the actions of obedience, all of the acts of worship, تظهر بفعلها وقل أن يسلم ما يظهر من شوب بخلاف الصوم. There is no action, there is no righteous deed that is done by anybody except that showing off can go into the mere action of doing it. يعني when somebody is praying, he can show off in his prayer. If a person wants to give charity, he can show off just by giving the money. But fasting, the mere action cannot be showing off. Because no one really knows if you're fasting. And that's very important. Ya'ani, fasting, the scholars, they mention the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. That fasting is for me, is that when a person chooses not to eat or drink, that means they have only done it for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's sake. So it resembles a tawheed. It resembles an ikhlas. The second pillar in Islam after tawheed is fast, is praying. The second pillar in Islam is prayer and salah. And this month of Ramadan, it shows the concept of prayer. ولذلك, that's what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in a hadith, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Anyone who stands in prayer in the month of Ramadan, إيمانا, in faith of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, واحتسابا, hoping reward from Allah سبحانه وتعالى, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. His sins will be removed and he will be expiated and forgiven for his past sins. Yani praise. The month of Ramadan is a month of salah. Rather, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith, innahu man qama ma'al imam. Anyone who stands with the imam hatta yansarif, until the imam leaves the prayer, kutiba lahu qiyamu layla. What will be written for you is as though you stood up the whole entire night. Yani if you say Allahu Akbar with the imam and you pray with him and you carry on until the witr, and you say salamu alaykum with the witr, يعني you leave the whole entire, you pray the whole entire salah with the imam, you are going to get the reward of praying that whole night, even if you sleep. ولذلك الإمام أحمد رحمه الله was asked, يعجبك أن يصلي الرجل. Does it fascinate you? Do you like for a man to pray by himself? Or do you like him to pray with the people? Which one do you prefer, Abu Ahmed ibn Hanbal, the great Imam? Do you like a man to pray with the people, to pray with the Jama'ah, or do you like him to pray by himself? And Imam Muhammad, he said, يصلي مع الناس. He prays with the people. That's what fascinates me. And he used to say, يعجبني أن يصلي مع الإمام ويوتر معه. What fascinates me and I like and I appreciate is that a man prays with the Imam and he does witr with the Imam. So the Salah, it manifests in the month of Ramadan. ولذلك ابن الجوزي رحمه الله, he said, شهر جعله الله مصباح العام وواسطة النظام وأشرف قواعد الإسلام المشرفة بنور الصلاة والصيام والقيام. This is a month Allah تبارك وتعالى has truly brightened it, and Allah تبارك وتعالى has made it in the middle. And He سبحانه وتعالى, in this month Allah تبارك وتعالى erected inside it and established inside it the principles of Islam, the symbols, the true symbols of Islam are found in this month, like as-salah, praying and fasting, and also standing up for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Ramadan, it shows the concept of sadaqah is also in it, and giving. And this is a month that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most generous person. ولذلك عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما, he said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أجود الناس. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the most generous of people. وأجود ما يكون في رمضان. And he was most generous in the month of Ramadan. حين يلقاه جبريل وكان جبريل عليه السلام يلقاه في كل ليلة من رمضان. فيدارسه القرآن فلرسول الله أجود بالخير من ريح المرسلة. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the most generous of people, and his generosity will multiply in the month of Ramadan. He would give more than he would give in any other time of the year. So Ramadan is connected to sadaqah and giving. This shows you, subhanallah, that one act has in it the pillars of Islam. Abu Bakr ibn Abi Maryam, he mentions, ذكر Abu Bakr ibn Abi Maryam عن أشياخه, he mentioned from his shiyukhs and his teachers, أنهم كانوا يقولون, that they used to say, إذا حضر شهر رمضان, if the month of Ramadan enters, فانبسطوا فيه بالنفقة, open yourselves and give whatever Allah has given you, the sadaqah, give wealth, give what you have. فَإِنَّ النَّفَقَةَ فِيهِ مُضَاعَفَةٌ كَالنَّفَقَةِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. The reward is multiplied, and it's like giving out in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this month, they used to urge the Salaf al-Salih, the pious predecessors, they will encourage the people to give. And Imam al-Shafi'i, he said, أُحِبُّ لِلْرَجُلِ الزِّيَادَةَ فِي الْجُودِ فِي شَهْرِ رَمَضَانِ اقْتِدَاءً بِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ولحاجة الناس فيه إلى مصالحهم ولتشاغل كثير منهم بالصلاة بالصيام والصلاة عن مكاسبهم. الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله he said, I love for a man to be generous in this month of Ramadan, to follow and imitate the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, because the need that the people have for someone to give to them in this month is great, because they're busy with ibadah. People are busy with salah and salah and sawm and other acts they are busy with. For them to find someone who can give to them, it's something great. ولتشاغل كثير منهم بالصوم والصلاة عن مكاسبهم. Many of the people are busy with what? They are busy in fasting. They are busy in praying for them to go to work. Some of them have closed their shops, closed their business for the month of Ramadan. So if you have wealth and Allah has given it to you to bestow upon those people. The final and last act, which is pillar of Islam, is al-Hajj. Ramadan is connected to Hajj. You might wonder and ask yourself, how? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, فَإِنَّ عُمْرَةً فِي رَمَضَانَ. Umrah that is done in the month of Ramadan, تَقْضِي حَجَّةً مَعِي. It's equivalent to a Hajj with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Imagine that. Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated that in his Sahih. Ibn al-Arabi, the great Maliki scholar, Ibn al-Arabi al-Mu'arraf, he said, هو فضل من الله ونعمة فقد أدركت العمرة منزلة الحج بانضمام رمضان إليها. He said, this is a virtue from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and it's a blessing that it is bestowed upon His creation. And Umrah has reached the station of Hajj. And Umrah became like Hajj in virtue. Why? بانضمام رمضان إليها. Because Ramadan is with this Umrah. The reason why this Umrah has become equivalent to Hajj is because this Umrah has Ramadan with it. So it's fasting with Umrah. It's equivalent to Hajj. Not just Hajj, but Hajj with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's where Ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah, he said, فيه, in this is that, أن ثواب العمل يزيد بزيادة شرف الوقت كما يزيد بحضور القلب وبخلوص القلب. That an act, the reward for it can multiply or it even can become high based on the timing. يعني Umrah became high now because of the time. What time is this? It's the month of Ramadan. The same way an act, the reward can multiply based on the person's heart and how present that heart is. And also how distant that heart is from distraction and also disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So ponder here, my beloved brothers and sisters. Ramadan is Jami' al-Arkan. Ramadan combined the pillars of Islam. It brought at-tawheed. It also brought salah. It also brought sadaqah and zakat. It also brought hajj. And it also has in it fasting. And that doesn't require explanation and evidence for it. It's a month that in it is the pillars of Al-Islam. All of it are done and the rewards are multiplied. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bottom of my heart that He allows us to reach this blessed month and gives us the strength and power to benefit from it. And allows us subhanahu wa ta'ala to be those who He frees their necks from the hellfire. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.